P.S. I'm very serious about my career. I believe you. Hashtag psychologist to be. I believe you. Hashtag I believe you. So basically, our total fulfillment lies on different areas, okay? Career is one thing, okay? But you may not find fulfillment with that. I totally agree you're very serious about your exams, but if you have a crush or someone, if you want to have that intimate relationship with someone, pursue it. You know what I did? I had exam the next day, and Delhi Queer Pride happens in November, and I was not going to miss a chance to meet some beautiful lesbian at that time. So I studied and I went there and I found myself one. But anyway, besides the point, you do that, okay? You manage your life, you manage your career, everything, like think of holistic happiness, like she said, you know? Seek happiness. You have to seek it. You have to actively seek it. That's about it.
All right. Thank you, Divya. So I have this question to the woman in white dress. The overwhelming opportunities that the social media exposes you to, irrespective of how... Oh, is this you?
Woman in the white dress. But okay.
Should we read?
Okay. Sure.
Okay. You're the woman in the white sari, no? In the dress. The overwhelming opportunities that social media exposes you to, irrespective of how talented you are, you miss something always. True. Please talk about how FOMO can be a real, real problem for the best, most hardworking, the go-getters amongst us. Can you believe, day before yesterday, I was called by NewsX on a show called Fame and FOMO? And my parents asked me, what is FOMO? I had to tell them fear of missing out. I'm like, okay. I have a poem around FOMO, by the way, which I may or may not share, but I'll share it with MHFI, they can share. So, I believe life works in mysterious ways. If you found one opportunity and could not grab the other opportunity, do not worry. It will come back to you in another way at a later time when you're better prepared. Have faith, okay? We can't be in 10 places at once, but prioritize. So if MHFI was a priority, you made it happen, right? Similarly, we have 24 hours in a day. We need our sleep. We need to work on studies. I am right now in events and curation. I'm performing with jazz bands. I'm doing everything I wanted to do. Back in college, I couldn't. Why? Because I had my focus this time for this. Let me get my degree, let me work on this. And it's worked beautifully. Because at this point, I have 4 careers. I'm a working DJ, I have my first DJ set, I'm a poet, I'm a workshop curator, and I organize events. So you can have all these things, but focus on your studies and focus on different things when you have time. You have a long life ahead of you. There are a lot of opportunities. They'll come along. There's no FOMO. Maybe fame.
Okay. Quickly, because I got a cool note saying, 5, last question, please. 5 minutes, need to break. Because I think breaks are important part of mental health. I've got 3 lying here. So what I'll do is I'll give you chotu answers to 2, and we'll then catch these guys outside or anyone outside. And this one is for the lady in the white sari with the correct name. I think I'm colorblind because we white dress, mujhe color dikha. So, sorry. It says, firstly, I would like to thank Fortis Hospital for providing... Okay, yes, we did. That's the first half. Psychiatric consults at rupee 10 this week is something we were doing. So you could see a psychiatrist for only 10 rupees throughout the week. It's very instrumental helping people tackle their problems and also to learn more about psychology and access to it. And the question for you is, how can we stop romanticizing? How can we stop romanticizing mental health and mental disorders? As we have seen, even some of the counselors portraying it as something which is not normal. That's
not normal.
Normal. Yeah.
Wait, but how is romanticizing?
Yeah. Try reading it.
So I think breaking off into 2. How do you not romanticize disorders? No, but you have to. How do you not romanticize disorders? Basically, people believe depression leads to creation of beautiful art, Van Gogh ko dekho, ye sab ko dekho. not true, okay? They were miserable. You do not need to be miserable to create art. And that's one question. And those who do romanticize, you can be in a position and tell them, please do not romanticize a mental health condition. It's actually debilitating. The other question was, how can you... Where are we? And stop portraying it something which is not normal. Yeah, you take a stand. If your psychologist you feel doesn't have the right perspective, you raise your concern.
Yeah, then not right. Chhod do. Okay?
I'll just speak. Divya, you just said, yeah, I agree with you that depression doesn't lead to that. But that doesn't mean that if you are in a bad place or you're in a dark place, you can't create something beautiful. I was in a very dark place after my grandmom expired, and I created a book, and that was a bestseller. So honestly, you can create something amazing if you're also in a dark place. So I agree that we romanticize things, saying, okay, you know what, it's like only because we are dark we can do that. We both can. If you're happy, you can, and you're not. So I really feel that if you guys are and you're having issues, you can be a fabulous painter, you can be a fabulous author, or you can just be a great person. So I don't think there's any correlation. I personally don't think there's a correlation between the two.
Can I just add something over here quickly? Okay, so some of you may have heard of this person's name. The psychiatrist is called Viktor Frankl. And he's written a book called Man's Search for Meaning. And basically, he wrote this book out of his experiences of spending time in the concentration camp. And that is as bad as suffering goes. He lost his family there. He was made to do work with, you know, in freezing temperature with no shoes and given one bowl of soup every day. And from that, this book came out. And in fact, this was the third time he wrote. Two times his manuscript was destroyed. And what he writes is that you find meaning in three things in life: love, work, and suffering. But he made it an important point to make sure that he communicated that you don't have to suffer deliberately to find meaning. It's not like rockstar jaise aapko movie dikhati hai ki tere ko dard hoga to acha gaana niklega. Not like that. You know, when you happen to suffer, if you happen to suffer, and like I said in my talk, you will. There will be plenty of opportunities. So no need to romanticize mental illnesses, I believe. That is when you find out meaning in the suffering. Yeah, thank you.
Okay. Yeah, I know. Are you going to clap us off stage? So there are two left. What we'll do is either the people who unfortunately have gotten left can ask us separately, and we'll close for the day. But I think thank you for having us all here, and hopefully this was helpful. And thank you for all your questions, and the fact that you have a lot of them is fantastic in itself.
Thank you so much. I request Dr. Nanth to please felicitate our guests. We'll be resuming after 30 minutes with a performance by Sukhmanch and followed by poems by Harnit Kaur, Rakesh Tiwari, and Nizamu Bandhi.